Welcome to Bitch Talk, booze interviews straight from the heart of San Francisco. I'm Erin. That's Ange.
Hi.
That's Char.
Hello.
You can find us at bitchtalkpodcast.com where you can sign up for our monthly e-news.
For behind-the-scenes videos and two-minute clips of our interviews, head to our YouTube channel and subscribe.
You can find us every other Thursday morning at 9:30 a.m. at BFF.fm.
And if you like what you hear, rate and subscribe wherever you listen to podcasts. For the love of God, do it. It really helps.
Hey, Bitch Talkers.
Welcome to South by Southwest 2022, virtually, of course. We've already gotten through a dozen movies at this point, almost a dozen. And we still have more to come, but just wanted to get you all ready for all of our South by Southwest episodes that are coming your way. So I don't even know where to start.
Well, you said that we're attending virtually, but no one else is, apparently, because everyone that we have interviewed is like, oh no, we're going, everybody's going to be there but us. But that's okay, I don't have FOMO.
Exactly. I'm like, you guys keep telling me not to have FOMO, but it's just like every time I'm getting, it's like Sundance, right? Like where you're getting, I'm getting all the invites. And I'm getting like, oh, there's a party here. There's a softball and barbecue, you know, like in all these in-person stuff that can happen. But
it's okay. It's fine.
Well, that's why we need to go to Austin just separately and make friends that live there so we can stay with them when we cover South by Southwest. That's my plan, actually.
We do have friends there, actually.
Well, I don't.
Yeah.
If you do, you need to tell me who.
Okay.
Oh, sorry, Char. Who?
I think our director friend, Shauna Festy.
Oh, well, we're not going to stay with her. It has to be
why?
Like,
you just said friends. She likes
that's not
us.
A friend.
We'll take care of her kids.
That's an acquaintance. I mean, like a friend, like go and party and meet some people and be like, we're friends now. We're going to stay with you.
Yeah, no.
I'll do it. I've done that before.
I was about to say, that's what Angie does when she travels the world.
That's how I travel. Yeah,
I know. I've been with you.
And I made lifelong friends. So it works sometimes.
Well, you do have a friend in Austin.
Oh, God.
Who you just talked about over the weekend.
That was not a friend.
Several times.
Because Jeff kept bringing it up. Her partner kept bringing it up. I'm like, I don't care to talk about it anymore. Anyway, so we have seen some crazy shit so far, right? And we've had a lot of return guests, which is really exciting.
Which has been great. Yeah, I love the return guests.
Yeah, Alice Goo, who we loved, the Donut King, we covered last year at Campfest. And now she's back with a documentary that's completely different, but it was really great, called Really Good Rejects. So
yeah, if you're a music head, you're gonna really love that film. We had Milos and Fabian from Horse Brothers, who we had on in 2020. I thought it was 2019, so that's how time has warped, but 2020 for Tapeworm. They're both out of Canada and they're both going to fucking South by Southwest. Those assholes.
Again, everyone but us.
I was surprised that they're going, but sure. Fine, guys. Go without us.
And you're also going to hear a really cool conversation about Tupac.
Yeah.
we covered a short film called Dear Mama that has to deal with grief and healing and surrounded by Tupac. So, and Tupac's death. So that was really an exciting one for me because I just went to his exhibit in LA, Wake Me When I'm Free. So it was just crazy timing. I had just seen the exhibit and then days later we interviewed.
I was gonna say, are we allowed to even call it a period piece?
Well, during the halftime show, my friend's niece was calling the songs oldies. Are these oldies? Yeah. So I think 90s music is oldies now.
Ew.
I don't fucking know.
There's elements that are very specific to the mid-90s, early 90s. Yeah, in that short. But now it sounds like I'm talking about the 1800s. Anyway, it's all fun.
Well,
only gilded age.
It was 30 years ago, so.
Shut up, Char.
What is the newest generation now? Is it Z? Gen Z? Are they the newest one?
I thought Gen Z. No. What's... What's the newest generation, babe?
What comes after Z? I mean,
it is Zoomer.
Zoomer is after Gen Z. A Zoomer? Okay. Yeah, so Zoomers consider music from the 90s oldies. That was my point. Zoomer, that fucking sucks.
A Zoomer?
Because it's a horrible name. It's like it's the worst. It's like baby boomers, but Zoom. Like, who wants to be associated with Zoom?
Who's Zoom and who?
I'm seeing here Generation Alpha. Born.
No, a dog.
Ew.
Like a dog.
And alpha is a bad connotation. That's like toxic masculinity.
Alpha male. Yeah.
Right.
What? Who's making this shit up?
No idea. So yeah, Generation Z, according to this quick Google search I did, Generation Z is 1996 to 2010. Generation Alpha is 2011 to 2025.
I've never heard that ever, but
2011 to 2025. That's why that they're like 13. Who do you know in Generation Alpha? That's why we don't know about them, because we don't even fucking know them yet. They haven't gone to bars. Once they start going to bars, then we get acquainted with their generation. Okay.
Oh, you're Generation Alpha. You were born in 20.
Yeah. Are you going to go talk to some 8-year-old? Like being Generation Alpha? Anyway,
back to South by.
I will say this about South by Southwest. I think this is the best titles of things that we've watched out of any film festival. I'm just going to go down a quick line. Aspirational Slut. My Year of Dicks.
Yes.
Gay Haircut.
Gay Haircut.
Really good names this year. Bravo, everybody.
Yeah. I'm having fun watching the films. I'm going to sign up, I think, for some, talks like they had last year. I joked with the team here. Maybe I'll watch George W. Bush talk about being an artist again. But there's, but you know who's speaking is Maria Ressa.
I saw that. I'm going to watch that for sure.
I'm excited about, and I want to sign up for that. But one day we'll be there in person.
It's fine. I joke about FOMO, but it's fine.
No. Yeah.
Our time will come.
Timing wasn't happening this year.
And we're only halfway through our coverage, and we've already talked about women's reproductive rights. We've talked about Christian mothers of
LGBTQ
children. We've talked about we've really covered the gamut, and we still have a whole other week to go. So
I was just I started going online and making my RSVPs for the stuff that that we aren't going to have a chance to cover and do, and that's fun. It's just, I mean, there's just so many films. I know that when, behind the curtain, everybody, if you guys know our processes, we all kind of, Aaron makes a list, Ange makes a list of films, and we just kind of merge them together and then also what people pitch to us that we might be interested in that we might have overlooked. And our list this year was just huge. It was like, what, 40 titles at least, maybe?
That was just the first tier was 40.
Right.
There was another tier of like 20.
And Plan B. So I was going through the online queue and just kind of RSVPing for different things. And there's like a film about Tony Hawk. There's a film about Sheryl Crow, Mickey Mouse. 9 to 5 with Dolly Parton. There's just so much out there. I'm just like, it's almost like a content overload of between the stuff that we're actually already doing and interviewing for, and then the stuff that we're interested in, but we won't get to cover. It's like South by Southwest is just all over the place, but I guess they kind of thrive on the chaos from what I hear. So that's
what I hear too.
So that's what we're in for the next couple weeks.
Yeah. Yep.
But I'm really proud of us because this is the first time that we've really been ahead of the game and started doing a bunch of interviews before the festival even started. And we're over the bulk of our interviews, and it feels good to not just have the festival start and be like, running with our heads cut off.
I think that's what's kind of cool too, is that we're going to be able to kind of enjoy elements of the festival. Because usually during festival, in person or not, we're usually interviewing and doing and prepping and planning and doing all of these things and editing these shows together. But now I'm like, we're done with, you know, 75% of the interviews that we're doing. So now we can just kind of relax and like, oh, is this on right now? Let's go check this out.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Oh, I get now why it's alpha, because Z, they reached the end of the alphabet. So now they got to start at alpha A.
Yep. Okay.
Because I'm like, why of all things would you say fucking alpha? That's a horrible connotation to that word. Right?
Oh, I caught you. Yeah. I just like light bulb, the way the light bulb came back.
So yeah. That's good. All right. So you guys look forward to all of our South by Southwest coverage coming in the next couple of episodes. And in the meantime, listen to our latest episodes with Gabe Kapler, Lisa Ling. We have Helen Cho, who's fucking awesome, and Lisa Yadao, and comedian Daya Lakshminarayanan. Thanks so much for listening.
If you like what you hear, rate and subscribe wherever you listen to podcasts.
For more information about us, you can head to bitchtalkpodcast.com.
This podcast is created, hosted, and executive produced by Aaron Lim.
My co-host is Angela Tabora, a.k.a. Captain Party.
The show's edited by producer Shar.
We're powered by GoTo Productions.